If it's a continuing seizure, like let's say it's a violent seizure and it persists for more than 2 minutes at a time, then the first thing they should do is they should not panic. They should bring the patient to a safe area wherein the violent thrusting movements may not endanger the life of patient. For example, if they hit against a sharp object or if they fall down from a sofa, it could be dangerous. So they should be brought to a safe area. They should be placed in a sideways position. And very often we see that people tell us that they put some objects in the mouth or they give some objects in the hand, some metallic objects. So this should be avoided because this is not going to solve. Sometimes it can worsen the problems, especially putting some foreign bodies in the mouth. And if a seizure persists for more than 5 minutes, then the patient should be directly taken to an emergency unit. Like, as soon as the patient is brought to the emergency, we rule out certain common triggers like low blood glucose levels or low sodium levels, which are immediately treated. And like certain many of these conditions, you know, they are completely reversible. But if especially if it's a known epileptic and if it throws this recurrent seizures repeatedly, and if the seizure continues for a long time, it can happen many times when a person skips taking medications. So if this continues for more than 5 to 10 minutes, then there are chances that it can become resistant to treatment and then it may need an intensive care. If it persists for more than 30 minutes, then it becomes very difficult to treat. So that's why generally in these people we do advise some medicines which sometimes can be given in the house also if it's continuing for a longer duration. But nevertheless, if it persists for a long time, these patients should be immediately brought to the hospital, whichever is the nearest hospital.